For the second consecutive season, two of Illinois High School Volleyball's most storied programs collide on the biggest stage. From Redbird Arena, it's 40-1 Mater Dei and two-time defending champion Joliet Catholic for the Class 3A state championship. And we welcome you in courtside, Joe Davis, alongside former University of Michigan standout Megan Bauer. Same schools, different story this time, though.
Well, it keeps it interesting, doesn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, this year I think the roles have definitely changed. Joliet coming in as an underdog, which is new to them. Mater Dei, a little bit more of a veteran team. Both teams been here before. It should make up for an interesting match. Both playing for different reasons. Mater Dei coming off a loss last year to Joliet has a little bit of a vengeance. Joliet coming in as an underdog, trying to show them up.
Mater Dei's head coach is Fred Rockers, 35 seasons at the helm, one of two coaches in Illinois volleyball history with over 1,000 wins. He's got a junior class this season he says might be one of the best groups that he's ever coached. It's led by Brooke Schulte.
Well, one of the coolest things about Brooke Schulte is she's a junior, and she stepped up so much last year as a sophomore, and it shows how great of a leader she is and how her leadership skills have emerged in this year. And one of the interesting things is she's only a junior, and that means she has so much time in front of her to develop as a volleyball player, and it really shows when she's a leader of an offense in a program like Mater Dei, that shows a lot of her upside and what she has to offer as a volleyball player.
Now, Joliet Catholic, the two-time defending state champion, nobody even really expected that they would get back here this season. They returned just one key contributor from last year. It's Lainey Wyman.
Well, Lainey Wyman carries this offense, and that's for sure, and I think, you know, as a senior, she's a leader on this team, and she's shown the youth of this team how it's done. And she's been in this, she's a two-time state champion. She knows how it's done. She knows what it feels like to be here. So tonight, they're really going to look for that leadership. They're going to give her the ball in those pressure situations, and they're going to need her to terminate efficiently tonight.
Yeah, two-time state champion, and the chance for her to become just the seventh player in Illinois high school volleyball history to win three state championships in her career. So, if Lainey Wyman's going to accomplish that, what are the keys for her team and on the other side for Mater Dei?
Well, I think their ball control has to be key, and Mater Dei serves very aggressively, and they have to pass so they can get her the ball. And I think on the opposite end, Mater Dei has to serve aggressively to keep her out of the game. And Mater Dei just needs to play steady, good inside out. Both teams are so good and so aggressive, very physical volleyball teams. So just whoever can settle into their style of volleyball, gain some momentum, will be successful tonight.
Mater Dei searches for its first championship since 2001. And for Joliet Catholic, they look for their third in a row. We send you courtside now for introductions, PA announcer Carol Flores.
Good evening. Welcome to the IHSA Class 3A championship match between Mater Dei from Breese and Joliet Catholic Academy. Let's meet the coaches for the home team, the Knights of Mater Dei, who entered the match with a record of 40 wins and one loss. Please meet Coach Fred Rockers, who has a record of 1,045 wins, 200 losses in a 35-year career. And for the visiting team, the Angels of Joliet Catholic Academy, who entered the match with a record of 34 wins and 7 losses, please meet Coach Christine Scheibe, who has a record of 351 wins, 77 losses in an 11-year career. And now, let's meet the players. First, the non-starters. From Joliet Catholic, number 1, Darcy McClintock. From Mater Dei, number 14, Alyssa Hitpas. From Joliet Catholic, number 3, Kate Brown. From Mater Dei, number 15, Nicole Streaker. From Joliet Catholic, number 8, Jeanette Page. From Mater Dei, number 22, Ashley Rockers. From Joliet Catholic, number 9, Jordan Houston. From Mater Dei, number 23, Chelsea Crocker. From Joliet Catholic, number 10, Maggie Farner. From Mater Dei, number 24, Allie Lampin. From Joliet Catholic, number 12, Haley Pennington. From Mater Dei, number 25, Abby Lubers. From Joliet Catholic, number 13, Elena Ragusa. From Mater Dei, number 21, Bailey Campworth. from Joliet Catholic, number 14, Emily Shainstead. From Modern Day, number 17, Emily Kohling. And now, let's meet the starting lineup. For Joliet Catholic, a 5'7" senior, the captain of the Angels, number 2, Meredith Burton. And for Modern Day, a 5'10" senior, number 11, Allison Miller. For Joliet Catholic, a 5'10" junior, number 7, Kelly Fay. And from Modern Day, a 6-foot junior, number 13, Abby Winter. For JCA, a 6'2" senior, number 11, Lainey Wyman. And for Modern Day, a 5'10" senior, number 18, Kaylee Buckman. From Joliet Catholic, a 5'8" junior, number 6, Lauren Robertson. And for Modern Day, a 5'10" junior, number 12, Brooke Schulte. For Joliet Catholic, a 5'11" sophomore, number 15, Morgan Reardon. And for Modern Day, a 5'7" junior, number 10, Samantha Bedard. Rounding out the starting six for JCA, a 5'9" senior, number 4, Vanessa Owusu. And for Modern Day, a 5'10" junior, number 16, Kayla Eversgird. Introducing the liberos for both squads, for Joliet Catholic, a 5'3" junior, number 5, Jill Hickey. And for Modern Day, a 5'7" junior, Mallory Mensing. The floor officials for this match, Casey DeGutis and Paul Cermak, who serve as referees. Your line judges are Darnell Jones and John Holzer. Barb Maui serves the IHSA as the official coordinator. Let's play some volleyball.
The stage is set for the 3A state championship. For the second consecutive year, Breese Modern Day taking on Joliet Catholic. The Angels in search of their third consecutive state title. Modern Day in search of its first since 2001. Welcome into the Redbird Arena. Joe Davis alongside former University of Michigan standout Megan Bauer. And another heck of an atmosphere. You've got a couple of programs so storied, so much tradition. You're going to bring in crowds like this.
Absolutely, and these crowds are ready to see their team win, and they're going to be into this match from point one through the end of the match. It'll be a fun match, good rally, good volleyball.
Joliet Catholic, 34-7, fresh off a semifinal win over Marion Central. Straight sets yesterday. Modern Day, 40-1, second time in Fred Rocker's 35 seasons. He's eclipsed the 40-win plateau, and they rolled over Chicago Payton in yesterday's other 3A semifinal. We talked about it in the open, same teams, different stories leading in. Modern Day, number one team in the state in Class 3A. Joliet Catholic, nobody expected they would get back here. They lost just about everybody from last season's team. In fact, Lainey Wyman is the only player on Joliet this season that had a kill last season in the state championship. Modern Day returns 9 contributors from last season, and away we go with Meredith Burton's serve. Sam Bedard goes outside right away, and as Eversgird flies in, the wall is there. Then a point for JCA.
Looked like the set was a little bit tight there. Not much she could do with it.
Meredith Burton, captain of this team. And the senior sends it over. Alyssa hit pass drills one that Reardon can't handle. And we're tied at one early on.
Great swing there by Abby Winter. It looked like it was a quick set a few feet away from the setter. Brought her arm through. Joliet Catholic really has to make sure that they stay with her.
And Allison Miller gets a service ace right here. We're 41st of the season. second on the team. She'll play her college volleyball, Missouri S&T next season, formerly Missouri Rolla. And Breese Modern Day has not dropped a game in this state tournament. They hadn't dropped one in the state tournament last season until they faced JCA, and JCA took it in straight sets. It's the third straight year these two teams have met here at Redbird Arena. Of course, JCA winning the state championship match last year. Two seasons ago, the Angels took down the Knights in the semifinal. Meredith Verton goes outside for Morgan Reardon, and she's dug out by Alyssa Hitpass. Schulte leaves it to the middle. Hitpass flies up to bump it across, and outside, Lauren Robertson dug out by Eversgird. Schulte creeps it over the tape. It's still alive as Verton sends it wide.
Joliet Catholic had an opportunity there with a hitter swinging with no blockers. Those are balls that you have to bury. You have to end the rally there.
Nicole Streaker, a girl that Fred Rocker says in his 35 years of coaching is the most accurate server he's ever seen. Streaker now sets up outside for Kaylee Buckman, who misses long. So that gets us tied at three in the early going. And Lainey Wyman, the lone returner from last season's championship team that got into the scorebook. Streaker setting in the middle for Brooke Schulte, gets her first kill of the match.
Well, Schulte did a nice job of elevating here. She had pretty much anywhere she wanted to go on the court. Joliet Catholic has to know where she is on the court at all times and make sure they put up a big double block in front of her.
Ashley Rockers on an overpass converts, and three in a row for Modern Day.
Quick points like that always gain momentum.
Mallory Menzing is in now, played a key role yesterday, and Robertson's outside the antenna. Mallory Menzing, who has served right now, is the only girl on this team this year for Modern Day that wasn't a regular contributor last year. Reardon flies up to receive it. Owusu with an athletic play to even get it across. Streaker setting up Schulte, blocked back by Robertson.
Well, it looks like Joliet Catholic has had a few miscommunications between their setter and hitter. They have to make sure they know what they're running so that they're not sending over free balls to Modern Day. Modern Day is a team that will take advantage of those free balls.
Owen Robertson gets a service ace. Robertson had four consecutive aces yesterday in game two after Joliet had fallen behind Marion Central. The four aces put them in front and they stayed there.
Well, serving aggressive will be a key for Joliet Catholic, especially against an aggressive offense like Modern Day.
Menzing scrapes it off of the deck, but it's into the net. And we're tied at six. Robertson has a chance along with Vanessa Owusu and Lainey Wyman to be a part of three state championship teams. Only six other players in IHSA history have achieved that honor. Robertson out of the back row. Menzing was able to dig it outside to Schulte. Dug by Jill Hickey, long and part of a long line of Hickey sisters who have played here at the state tournament. And a kill from the outside to give Joliet Catholic the lead again.
Incredibly aggressive swing there, aiming for those deep corners. The perimeter of the court will be where they need to aim.
Robertson with another good serve. Rockers is blocked by Owusu and Reardon.
Well, Owusu's done a nice job of tracking her hitters. Make sure where all the hitters are coming from. Modern Day runs a dynamic offense, bringing people inside and outside. It's important that Owusu keeps doing a good job of tracking her hitters.
Owusu backed up Lainey Wyman last year. She's been very good this year, and she gets her second block in a row. So 9-6 Joliet Catholic. Largest lead of three. Robertson just gets it over the tape, her second ace of game one and her sixth in this state tournament.
Well, I credit this run to Lauren Robertson. She's coming out serving so aggressive, getting Modern Day off balance. That's so key for them the rest of this match.
This time she attacks Hitpass, who's there, and Eversgird hangs and pounds it down. Kayla Eversgird earned her way onto the floor as a sophomore last season. Rockers said it's been tough to take her off the floor since, so he just doesn't. Simple as that, I guess. Robertson with a great play on the back row, turns into the kill. And Joliet Kaplan with 7 of the last 8 points.
Well, an incredibly aggressive swing out of the back row. She went up swinging for a kill.
Service ace, Morgan Reardon. Alrighty, the third in game one for Joliet Kaplan. The lead is 5, and the sophomore Reardon lets it fly. Schulte's underneath this one, and out of the middle, here's Eversgood for the termination.
Eversgood doing a nice job of mixing up her shots. She sees the block in front of her and goes around it. She's cut shot. She makes it hard, very hard for the defenders to dig her.
Here's Sam Bedard, her third state tournament. Jordan Houston sets up Kelly Faye. And Kelly Faye converts. She entered the summer thinking she'd be a defensive player for Joliet. Coach Scheibe planted the seed in her mind of maybe transitioning to outside hitter. And then a high performance camp this summer, an instructor overheard her talking about it, gave her a shot, said, why don't you give it a try? And she's stuck there since. Lady Wyman with a block in the middle and the lead back to 6.
Big block there by Joliet Catholic, doing a nice job of just really keeping track of their hitters, putting up 2 big blockers in front of all attackers.
3-point pass to Bedard. Eversgood tools the block, and it's a good start to the match for the junior, who's got 3 kills.
Kind of an odd attack there coming from the outside the court. She's a lefty, so they have to set her inside the court. Coming off the blockers, make sure that they have to press into the court when they're blocking her.
Jordan Houston tried to find an opening. Sam Bedard closed it quickly, and from the outside, Allie Miller. First 2-0 run for Mater Dei since they scored 3 in a row for points 3 through 5. Eversgood floats it to the middle. Wyman receives it. Now on the slide play, pounds it down, but Bedard with a dig. Buckman floats it to the middle and nobody home.
Well, it's very important that they protect the middle of the court. You can see their wing diggers moving backward. All their weight was moving back to their repositions. It's important that they stay home until the setter releases the ball.
Jill Hickey over to Houston and Kelly Faye. Her second kill.
Kelly Faye really just attacking the blockers. Not trying to avoid them, just going right through them or around them. She's doing a nice job of staying aggressive early.
Meredith Verton started the match out with service. Now back there again, and the set from Bedard was way offline, leading to Lady Wyman.
Well, I like the way Joliet Catholic is taking care of the net. There have been a lot of balls that are just right around the net. Lady Wyman does a good job of just putting that ball on the floor.
Verton with an ace. You and I talked about it off of the air. Maybe the important things in matches like this between two powerhouses at the state level, the little things, and so far it looks like Joliet winning most of those little things.
Right, and I think, you know, both programs have such great talent in volleyball players that it's going to come down to those little points, those quick points that they've earned, the jousts, the overpasses that they have to take care of because they won't get those points back. These teams are too good. You know, sending free balls over won't happen that often, so when you get one, you have to execute. And I think Joliet Catholic has done a phenomenal job in the first set of taking care of those small points.
The Joliet Catholic faithful, some of them who spent this afternoon at the Joliet Catholic football game, and they were upset 16-14 this afternoon. Their season coming to an end. They're turning out in droves here at Redbird Arena. You talked about kind of the pressure of upholding tradition and the little things in a match like this. Well, for Joliet Catholic, even though nobody gave them a chance coming into this season, they said that they felt like they had to make it back because at this point, it's really what's expected at JCA.
Well, yeah, they're just used to winning, and that's what they expect now. They expect nothing less than to be a state champion, and that's the expectations that the young players have and that the players before them have set.
Lauren Robertson with a beautiful shot to the opposite corner. Robertson's first kill.
That corner shot is such a great shot because it really throws the defenders on the other team off. It's a hard ball to defend. The defenders have to cross pass. Somebody's got to get their hands on it.
Brooke Schulte reaches back, pounds one into the fist of Lainey Wyman, who sends it back for her second block. Lainey Wyman Chris Scheibe said she's had better all-around players before, but never somebody as good in the middle as Lainey Wyman. Now Morgan Reardon, who she says has a chance to be one of the best ever to play at JCA, knocks one back. And Lauren Robertson with a great play, one up by Alyssa Hitbass, but Notre Dame unable to convert.
Well, right now, Modern Day just isn't able to convert on much of anything. They can't get their offense going. They've been blocked multiple times, and then they get a grade up and weren't able to get it over the net. Right now, it just looks like they're a bit frustrated.
Abby Winter drops one over a double block inside of the line. Winter with her third kill, and Kelly Faye to serve it. And they gave that point to JCA. Yeah, this one's blocked out of bounds. Did you see the reason why they're playing it to JCA?
I didn't. I think there was a touch on that attack. Brooke Schulte did a nice job of coming back after hitting air, after tipping, and then just banging at the block. She has to continue to challenge that block.
And so it's 21-13 right now. Verton setting up Wyman, who destroys one straight down.
Wow. Well, she put that ball on the ground with a purpose.
Shades of Megan Bauer. Wyman now serving. JCA up 9, and Modern Day got to be shocked at this point. Ashley Rockers with an open spot in the back row. No relation to head coach Fred Rockers. Said maybe some relation, fourth or fifth cousin. He said there's a bunch of us running around. And a Remenzing serves. Reardon has trouble controlling it. And Kelly Faye with a roll shot that Eversgird picks up. Streaker outside to Schulte, who has to adjust and use her left hand. Now Reardon off of the block and down.
Well, right now, Modern Day has just got to slow this game down. It looks like it's going a little bit faster for them. Mistakes are coming in numbers. They need to get a good side out right here and just try to gain momentum going into the second set.
Timeout for Fred Rockers. And Megan, it's funny that you say that, because Fred Rockers talked about yesterday in the Chicago Peyton match, the faster the match went, the more it was in their favor. What's the difference when you're facing a superior team?
Well, I think, you know, especially right now when things aren't going well and they're a bit shooken up and this is a big match and they're expected to win, and that can add pressure. So I think right now Joliet Catholic is pushing the pace of this match. They're running back to the service line, serving really fast. Their offense is in a rhythm. Everything's going right for them. Modern Day has to find a way to slow this match down and get in their rhythm, and then they can speed it up when they catch up to the game. But right now it's just ahead of them and they're trying to chase it.
Joliet Catholic students out here hoping to see championship number 3, and Lauren Robertson hoping to get her third championship ring. Robertson with 2 kills so far. She's also got 2 service aces. JCA, 2 points away from a game 1 win. Menzing with an overpass, and Reardon makes her pay to set up game point. It's a 10-3 run for the Angels. Robertson sends it away. Schulte, 3-point pass for Streaker, and back to Schulte on the slide play. Schulte gets the kill. It's only her third of the match. And she storms to the back line to serve.
Well, Joliet Catholic has done a phenomenal job of not letting Modern Day score easily. They have to work for all their points, and that can be frustrating if you're not used to that.
Jill Hickey sends it over. Great effort all around defensively, combining with Houston, and Miller goes into the net. And for just the third time this season, Modern Day drops a set to a school from Illinois. And for the second season in a row, their first loss of a game in the state tournament comes at the hands of the Angels in the state title. 25-15 Joliet Catholic in game 1 in the 3A state championship. Joe Davis, Megan Bauer back at Redbird Arena on the campus of Illinois State University. Ready to get started with game 2 of the Class 3A state championship. Joliet Catholic. Nobody gave them a shot to get back here, despite the fact that they won back-to-back championships. They're back, and they top Modern Day 25-15 in set number 1. And Megan, when you look at Modern Day, a team that last 3 trips to state dating back to 2005, 05, 08, and 09, and sent packing by JCA, how much of that is playing a factor inside the heads of the modern day players?
Well, I think it's huge. Yeah. I think, you know, when you get down early in the first set, you already have pressure on yourself as being the team that's supposed to win. And it's unneeded pressure, but there's automatic pressure there. And then you lose the first set and you're thinking, well, boy, this feels familiar and it's a scary feeling. So they have to play without fear in this second set and just kind of settle into their rhythm. Have confidence in what they've done all season.
Lady Wyman is blocked by Schulte. Wyman right back at Schulte. Bedard flips for the corner, but Jill Hickey's waiting. Lady Wyman blocked by Schulte again. The two stars from these teams going at it for the first point. Here's Verton, back set. Robertson buzzes over the head of Alyssa, hit passing out of bounds.
It's a great rally. Both teams taking big swings. It was a nice shot down the line. She's just got to bring her arm through a little bit faster.
Schulte to the floor. Bert Schulte was quiet in that first set, just 3 kills. Schulte had 10 kills in the championship match last season against JCA. Tied in the net for Verton. She can't control it.
The Joliet Catholics having a hard time controlling this serve. They need to keep it on their side of the net. Get a good pass so that they have those options of hitters that they did in the first set.
Verton off of a 3-point pass outside of Robertson. It's Buckman deflecting it. And now Faye into the net. And a 4-0 run to begin things for Modern Day in game two. Buckman, Schulte, and Winter in the front row. 3-point pass to Verton, back set for Faye. This time she cuts it across and Sam Bedard gets a hand on it and makes it 5-0 Knights.
Well, those are momentum plays right here. Just get a great touch off the hard attack and it falls. Those are quick momentum plays that we talked about earlier.
Hit pass serve picked up in the back by Hickey. Robertson looking to kill the rally. Blocked back by Winter. Second chance for Robertson, but flat-footed. Scraped off of the deck by Brooke Schulte. Here's Robertson rolling it over the tape. Bedard searching for the corner, but too strong. And JCA finally onto the board in set number two.
Well, right now, Modern Day is beating Joliet in their own game, serving aggressive and blocking. And that's what worked so well for Joliet in the first game.
Kelly Faye's serve. Lainey Wyman misses wide. It was teed up for. She smashes it out of bounds. 6-1 Modern Day in the early going of game two. Nicole Streaker comes on. Sam Bedard goes out. Coach Rocker says if Streaker misses on a serve, he's going to collapse because it just doesn't happen. The best server he's seen in 35 years of coaching as his fifth cousin, Ashley Rockers, puts one down to make it 7-1. Streaker eats up Reardon. Service ace, 8-1. Nicole Streaker, headed to Missouri next year, not to play volleyball. She'll study physical therapy. Robertson blocked by Schulte. Rockers poked it down, but Wyman slid underneath, and Reardon pops it over. 3-point pass to Streaker, and outside for Schulte. Faye bumped it over. Good chance for the Knights. Outside to Buckman, who converts. 9-1 Knights.
Well, right now you can really feel Modern Day coming into their game like we talked in the break. It's so important that they come out aggressive and not afraid to lose, but ready to win.
What do you think the message was between games? What type of message would make you come out like that after really getting shut down in the first game?
Well, I think they were kind of shocked that entire game, and it went so fast that it just kind of was out of their hands. And they said, I think they did a nice job of regrouping and said that we played nothing like ourselves that game. Let's just play like ourselves, start out strong, get a good early lead, and it's exactly what they've done.
We've seen some of the smiles wiped off of the faces of the Joliet team as well. Now, last two championship teams, back-to-back seasons, they've thrived on the pressure. This team is different, though. They prefer to be loose, and Coach Scheibe knows they're locked in when she sees them smiling, but it drives her nuts because it's not her style. 9-1 Modern Day. Streaker serves it. And then Verton sitting outside for Reardon, who's blocked by Buckman. Reardon blocked again, this time by Rockers, and now a joust at the net. Robertson pushes it past Schulte, who has a shot over the double block. Burton recovers nicely. And Schulte tools the block for the kill. What a sequence for Brooke Schulte. You talk about scrapping.
Well, that was just pure hustle. I mean, she was jumping, trying to get those blocks at the net. Got knocked down, got back up, and then got the kill. And that's just great hustle play.
Overpass from Hickey turns into a kill for Rockers. 11-1, Modern Day. After dropping the first set 25-14. Another overpass. Roofing violation this time on Rockers.
The ball has to cross the plane of the net for it to be a fair ball for Modern Day to go get. Ref says it didn't.
Here's Lainey Wyman. Attacks Ebersgerd. Streaker just punches it over where Wyman was waiting. Outside for the sophomore Reardon, who tools the block for the kill.
Right now, down 8 points, they have to make sure that they inch their way back in. Every time they go back to serve, they have a mentality, I'm serving aggressive, we're winning this point.
Lainey Wyman to serve again, a line drive picked up by Schulte. Streaker sets up outside for Schulte, who's blocked back. Second chance, Wyman dives for a dig. Reardon with a shot to the corner, dug out by hit pass. Schulte with another chance, no dig in that one.
Well, Schulte's done a nice job. She doesn't get that first kill. She's off the net quick to get a big approach for her second swing, and she did just that on the last play.
How about those ups? They say she's got a 34-inch vertical. Verton for Reardon, but into the net. So a 10-point advantage for the Lady Knights. 40-1, nationally ranked, and looking to win a state championship. Robertson off of the double block, diving play by Eversgood to keep it alive. Now Wusu bumps for Robertson and outside to Reardon. Now Verton back to Robertson again, coming from all angles but missing outside. And how about this block lately for Modern Day?
Well, they're really doing a better job of tracking their hitters, and I think right now Joliet's mixing the ball around a lot. So the middle blockers for Modern Day have to be very active on knowing who they're gonna set.
Morgan Reardon that time. Reardon gets her sixth kill, that leads the team. And Lauren Robertson has got a couple of aces so far, back to serve it. Mallory Menzing receives it, 3-point pass. And way long from Eversgerd. Schulte out of the back row. Her seventh.
Big swing there by Schulte from the back row. Instead of just roll shotting it over, which we saw a lot from Modern Day in the first set, she's coming at him swinging for kills.
Schulte serves, not a top spin. Good job by Kelly Fay to grab it. Now Reardon just bumps it across. And from the outside, into the antenna goes Allison Miller. Allison Miller just one kill so far. That's her third air in this championship match. Lauren Robertson in the front row as Reardon serves it. Perfect pass and a set from Streaker that's pounded by Eversgerd. A lift is called on JCA and it's 16-6. Abby Winter into the front row. Tallest player on this team. The only six-footer for Modern Day. Sam Bedard to serve. Third season on varsity. Ton of club experience, too, and I know you played club volleyball. How much did that experience help you on a big stage like the state championship?
Well, I mean, it got you a lot of experience. You played a lot of matches in club. You know, you go to tournaments and play 12 matches at some point, and you're playing against the best team. So you're used to playing in big matches, and so when you come here, it helps you out. You have experience. It just adds to your experience that you can rest upon when you're in big matches.
Jill Hickey just gets it across. Allison Miller into an open spot. All Knights in game two. KCA took game one, 25-15. It was only the third game that Modern Day had dropped this season against opponents from Illinois. Kelly Phan, one that's set tight in the net, goes into the net.
But right now it just looks like Joliet cannot connect. They get a good pass, the set's off. They get a good set and the attack's off. It's just putting it all together that's a problem for them right now.
And a lift on JCA all starts with a poor pass.
Right, and that's always the key to a good rally. You have to start the rally with a good pass and build upon that. It's so important that ball control is your first thing that you focus on in each rally.
And this is more of an offensive-minded team in Joliet Catholic than they've been in the past. Last year, really defensive-oriented Anne-Marie Hickey in the back row, Stephanie Kekka, Lisa Warren, players like that. Very balanced this season, more weapons offensively. Block has improved, some better jumping ability for the team, mainly because Lainey Wyman has really exploded onto the scene. But at least in game two, the offense, nor the defense, I guess, has been there for JCA.
Well, I think it's just game two. I think they have the skill and the ability to win this match. But right now, they just have to put their nerves aside and just play volleyball. Right now, they got a little bit too excited after the win in game one, and they have to make sure that they connect all of the pieces. Right now, it looks like a bit of individuals playing. Instead, they have to go back to that team mentality that they had in the first set.
Kayla Eversgird with service. Lainey Wyman down the middle. Brooke Schulte was there to dig it out. Eversgird. Send it across. Houston with the back set on the slide play for Wyman. Great job by Sam Bedard to even touch it, but it's a kill for Wyman.
Well, that was one of the first slide attempts we've seen from Wyman, and I know she's good at it. Joliet has to take that risk to get her the ball, especially when you're down. You have to make sure you're taking risk because risk will get you reward.
Bedard goes outside. Buckman's blocked back. Lainey Wyman, Lauren Robertson with a rejection. Meredith Furton serve, dives into the back row. Back set from Bedard. Miller was dug out by Hickey. Now they set up Kelly Faye. Off hands in Eversgird. Here's Buckman again. Hickey with the dig. Wyman, Eversgird punches it up. Out of the back row, Schulte misses way long.
Schulte coming from the back row with a ton of momentum through that swing. It just went a little bit long.
The first 3-0 run in this second game for JCA. A slide play for Modern Day turns into a facial out of the right hand of Abby Winter hitting Kate Brown.
What an incredible swing there by Abby Winter. On the slide approach, it just looked like Joliet lost her. No blockers up on her.
Do you ever take a facial?
Oh yeah, you take it and then you act like it never happened.
Lainey Wyman gets a kill and cuts it to 9. How many did you deliver? Can you count?
A few, but okay. I also took a few.
Okay. Kelly Faye, whose mom brings in the post-game treats for the Angel. Sugar cookies are the best, says Coach Scheibe. And Schulte gets another down the middle. It's her 8th, and Modern Day continues to roll in game two.
Well, it looks like Modern Day is really settling into their offense, setting up plays and executing them perfectly back to what they were used to doing.
Nicole Streaker serves, and Hickey with a reception. A long set for Reardon. Popped up by Buckman. Wyman and Hickey recovering. Outside for Robertson, who flips it over the double block. Now Schulte. Verton and Reardon with that long reach plugs it to the middle.
Well, she does such a nice job of the sets outside, bringing it in and hitting that sharp cross court.
Reardon's 7th kill leads Joliet Catholic. And the senior captain, Lainey Wyman, back to serve. Diving up to save it was Eversgird. Verton back set for Owusu, blocked by Schulte. First block for Schulte.
Big block there, did a nice job of tracking Owusu. Knows she likes to go on the side attempt on a good pass. Nice heads up play.
Reardon again with long reach, pounds it to Menzine. From the outside, Schulte gets blocked. Robertson and Owusu combining. Jordan Houston comes in as Lauren Robertson goes back to serve, and Houston joins the front row of Owusu and Reardon. JCA with serve down by 9. Menzing can't control it, and Lauren Robertson with her 7th ace at the state tournament. Menzing controls this one nicely, allows Streaker to set up Schulte. But Schulte misses outside, and it's 3-0 for JCA. Lauren Robertson, the coach's dream, says Chris Scheibe, because of her versatility. She can do it all. Hit, pass, set, play defense. As we've seen, she can serve too. Faye with the dig. Houston comes to get it to set up Reardon, who somehow finds a spot on the floor in front of Menzing. And it's the
nice
first 4-0 run.
Back to that deep corner we talked about earlier. It's a hard ball to defend. As you can see, those defenders have to cross pads. It's kind of a no-man's zone. Someone has to take it.
And Fred Rockers takes a timeout. 4-0 run for JCA. They've cut it to 6 after winning game 1, 25-15. And you notice Fred Rockers not inside the huddle during this timeout. Now his son, Chad Rockers, also a coach on this team, and he handles the discussion during timeouts.
I bet they discuss what he's going to talk about
before the timeout. Dad just says to son, okay, this is what you're going to tell them. You can be the figurehead, but
I bet there's a little bit of that.
Okay. He has been around a while. I think he's still probably got some input. We talked yesterday in the press conference, the very best teams, the girls that win the most games, the teams that are most special, they eat out of the hand of the coach. And his point was, there is no, okay, that sounds okay, I think we can do that. It's yes, coach. And he said this group, special partly because they do that.
Right, and I think it's important that you buy into what your coach is telling you in the game that you're going to play. If you buy in to what your coach is telling you and everybody's on the same page and going in the same direction, that always helps.
That's Brooke Schulte's 6th there in the championship match. Lauren Robertson to serve, and a 5-0 run for JCA. Almost turns into 6, but hit passes there. Eversgaard dug out by Jill Hickey. Houston, bump set for Reardon. Fades away outside of the corner.
A little bit of hesitation on the Joliet side. The setter didn't know who was going to get the serve. Those are the type of plays that they have to execute, especially when they're trying to come back in a second set.
Schulte with a jump serve. A rocket dives down to the floor, and a service ace. No chance for the back line of JCA to receive that. And it's game point for Notre Dame. 25-15 in game 1 to JCA. Houston for Owusu, and JCA still alive in the second set.
Well, I think Joliet got away from setting their middles, and part of that is not having the ball control they did in the first set. They aren't able to have that option. But they really have to take advantage of the opportunities of when they can get the ball in the hands of their middles.
Morgan Reardon serves. Picked up by Eversgaard, a back set for Ashley Rockers. Owusu tips it up, but it's down, and Notre Dame forces game 3. A completely different team in the second game, 25-18. And we've got a third set in the 3A state championship on IHSA TV. Bradley scoring to 25 to decide the 3A state champion. Game 1 to Joliet Kaplan, 25-15. Notre Dame respond for the 25-18 win in game 2. Joe Davis courtside with Megan Bauer. And you get into a game 3 in any match, obviously some added pressure, some added jitters. You're going through the heads of these players. Game 3, state title on the line.
I think you have a little bit of nerve, but it's very, very important that both teams stay aggressive. In my head, the most aggressive team will win this set. They're very evenly matched. They both do great things. They both have great offense, and they both have great experience. So, you know, there's a lot of things that are even there, but it's just who's going to make less errors but be really aggressive.
Away we go in game 3. Meredith Burton with a serve. Back set for Abby Winter, who tools the block.
Well, we've seen Abby Winter go off of 1 foot behind the setter and in front of the setter. Very dynamic middle blocker.
Notre Dame this season only 2-0 in 3 set matches. Joliet Catholic 8-3. Laney Wyman with a change of pace to tie it at 1. Lainey Wyman, the only player on this JCA team that had a kill in last season's state tournament. She has seven this year. And a serve from Faye picked up in the back row. Outside to Brooke Schulte. Hickey can't get it.
Well, Brooke Schulte doing a nice job of mixing up her shots. First time I've seen her hit down the line tonight with pace. It's important that she keeps mixing up those shots.
Meredith Verton, back set for Wyman in the slide play, couldn't get it over. When you talk about mixing up those shots, what do you exactly mean?
Well, I think Schulte's done a nice job of hitting cross court. She'll tip every once in a while, but she's only tipped down the line, and that time she brought a little bit of pace down the line. So you got to make some, move the ball around the court.
Hickey was there that time underneath the attack from Schulte. Now Faye out of the back row. Hit pass, tracks it down. Schulte to send it over on the third touch. Here's Verton setting over for the sophomore Reardon. Another dig for hit pass. JCA trailing 3-1 in set number three. Lauren Robertson connects and makes it 3-2.
Both teams working so hard right now, keeping the ball off the floor, making each other take more than one swing to find a kill. This is a good match between good two teams, and we're going to see a lot of long rallies.
Annie Wyman serve, three-point pass from Schulte. They go right back to her. She gets blocked by Robertson, but coverage there from Kayla Eversgerd. Here's the set to Reardon, and a rocket again picked up by Eversgerd. Schulte hangs and gets rejected. Robertson and Owusu. Well, Owusu, just 5'9". Chivy says she plays like she's 6'2". All tied up at three. Wyman serve. Out of the back row, here comes hit pass. And a lift is caught. And Meredith Furton.
Got to make sure that you get back on defense fast. Right when you see she set the back row, Wing Diggers have to bust to get back in defense so they don't have to take it with their hands in that situation.
Burton's blocked by Robertson. Brooke Schulte got it. Schulte 9 kills in this match. That's her third block. Natalie Menzing back to serve with Hunter Day in front by 2. Burton tracks it down and feeds Reardon. Here's Menzing to streak her and across. Three-point pass for Verton, slide play Owusu. Menzing with a dig. Menzing slaps it over on the third touch again. And Reardon with a good chance. It's Eversgerd to knock it back. What a set there from Schulte. Eversgerd somehow able to touch it, get it across. And now Robertson puts it into the net. A 3-0 run for Mater Dei, who didn't have much life in that game one. Came out firing out to an 11-1 lead in game two. Here we are in game three. That's long and a 4-point lead for Mater Dei.
A few hitting errors in this run. Frustrating Joliet right now. They have to make sure they're aggressive. They got to get that ball inbounds. Keep swinging, trying to hit around that block.
Burton down the middle for Robertson. Somehow the defense for Mater Dei gets to it. This time it's Reardon. Menzing pops it high in the air. Schulte flies up, converging with Rockers. Reardon again.
Reardon having to work really hard for that kill. She's taken a lot of swings in this third set. Mater Dei doing a good job of keeping him off the floor. It's a bit frustrating. She has to realize Mater Dei is going to defend the ball. It may take more than one swing to get a kill.
Eversgerd gets it. Kayla Eversgerd, kill number 5.
Eversgerd, a small outside hitter, but she makes up for it with a really fast arm swing. Beats the blocker's hands over the net, makes sure she swings really fast.
Brooke Schulte tosses it high in the air, launches one wide. Joliet Catholic and Morgan Reardon with serve down by 3. Morgan Reardon just a sophomore. Chibi said she could be the next long line of Gatorade Players of the Year at JCA. Rockers gets the kill. It's 9-5 Mater Dei, and they bring Abby Winter back into the game, sending Sam Bedard back to serve it. Bedard misses wide. Now Jill Hickey back to serve. Jill with two older sisters, both with rings. Her sister Katie in 2008, Anne Marie in 2009. Jill said she'd love to get one of her own for bragging rights back at home. Jill's grandmother, Pat Hickey, has been a big fan of all three championship runs for her granddaughters. And each of the last two seasons, Joliet Catholic struggled against St. Francis in the sectional level of the tournament. This season, Grandma Hickey said that she was nervous at first when JCA was struggling, but then she reached into her purse and found a tissue from last season's St. Francis match and knew she was fine because the tissue was good luck. Do you have any tissues in your purse from a year ago?
No. No, okay. I do not.
10-7 the lead for Mater Dei. The side out gives the serve to Kayla Eversgert. Here's Faye into the antenna.
Again, Joliet really struggling with attack errors. Trying to find their offensive rhythm. Moving into the second half of the set, it's very important that they become a little bit more efficient and find the floor more frequently.
Faye finds the floor, the middle of the floor. Mater Dei is not trailed in this third and decisive set. Winner takes home the 3A state championship. If it's Joliet, it's their third in a row. If it's Mater Dei, it's its first since 2001. That goes into the net, the lead to four. Melissa hit pass comes on to serve. Burton for Hickey, blocked back by Buckman and Winter. Robertson is blocked by Buckman and Winter.
Right now, Joliet really needs someone to put the ball on the floor. They got to end this rally.
Burton digs it out. Wyman able to keep it alive, so Faye can flip it over for a kill. Wasn't pretty, but it got the job done. And after Faye gets her fifth kill, she now goes back to serve. Junior outside hitter. Picked up by Eversgert. Three-point pass to Bedard, and Winter lifts it.
Looked like a little bit of a miscue there. Yeah. Not sure who is going to take that ball over the net. Quick point here for Joliet.
Again, the offense a bit out of sync. Robertson to set up Reardon from the outside.
Morgan, and that's a Reardon. Big swing. That's a big swing. That's a veteran swing. Down the line, just really elevated herself and swing with purpose.
Veteran swing from a sophomore. Cuts it to two. Bedard, Winter, able to tip it down off the hands of Reardon.
It's a nice string of points Joliet put together. A great side out by Mater Dei. Joliet really needs to side out quickly. They can't afford to let Mater Dei go on any more runs.
The pass from Hickey, Verton to Wyman, who mistimed her jump. They give it another shot. This time Robertson. Blocked by Rockers, but too long. That tells you how hard it was hit.
Well, she got up, swing. Really hard, brought her arm swing through fast, able to get a nice touch.
JCA has it down to two, but Laney Wyman, the senior, misses long and has that look on her face like, what am I doing?
Well, Joliet has to be smart here. They're trying to get within, tie this ball game up, and right now they're missing a lot of serves, making it hard for them to do that.
Burton takes Robertson off her line, but she's able to just chip it to the middle. Creativity from Lauren Robertson. Haven't been within one since it was 4-3. Robertson attacks hit pass. Streaker off her line. Hit pass out of the back row. And tools the block attempt of Owusu.
Urusu, if she's going to go up and block, she has to block with purpose. She kind of just threw her hands in the air that time, allowing a down ball to hit the ground.
Here's Brooke Schulte. On a team full of stars, she's the star. Owusu from the outside. Blocked by Rockers, and it's inside of the line. Rockers' fourth block. Timeout for JCA. Angels win game one with ease by 10. Modern Day comes back in game two. They take an 11-1 lead, roll to tie things up at a game apiece, and have led from the outset in game three at 17-13. And Megan, what do you think for JCA here down the stretch? What has happened in the first set that hasn't in these last two?
Well, I think that they came out in the first set extremely aggressive. They were serving well. They weren't letting Modern Day really get into their offensive rhythm, and I think that they have allowed that in the last one and a half sets. And the key for the rest of this match for Joliet is going to be we have to serve aggressive, but we have to serve inbound as well. They killed themselves a few times with missed serves trying to crawl back into this set, and they have to limit streaks for Modern Day.
Red Rockers in search of his sixth state championship. It's the 20th time in 35 seasons as a head coach he's brought his team to the state tournament. Brooke Schulte serves. Good reception by Lauren Robertson. Owusu tips it over the top of Miller, but she's into the net, and it's 18-13 Modern Day. Three straight for the Knights. Houston goes outside. The sophomore reared in with a rocket to the line. Here's Morgan Reardon to serve. Eversgood has a tough time getting it. Miller for Rockers. Coverage from Houston. A lift. Double hit is called.
Well, not a miscommunication you can afford. They did a nice job of getting Modern Day out of system on their offense. They got a free ball and then were able to execute. There has to be someone to take control in those situations.
For the last five for Modern Day, Sam Bedard serves. Here's Jordan Houston again. They go outside. This time Kelly Fay. Winter knocks it back. Houston in search of the middle of the floor. From the back row, Schulte gets it to trickle down, but it's recovered by Reardon. Diving play, Schulte in the back row. Back set for Eversgood, but a double hit. Brooke Schulte diving all over the place, showing why he's one of the top players in the state. And Jill Hickey in search of her own ring. Down by four, and set number three serves it. Here's Bedard setting up Miller. It's only the third kill for Allison Miller in this match. And Modern Day 5 points away. Kayla Eversgood serves it. Jordan Houston off of the three-point pass on the slide play. And how about Lainey Wyman changing it up over the double block with a tip instead of that cross court?
Well, right now for Joliet, tips are falling on the Modern Day side. They have to keep remembering that. Make Modern Day earn their points.
Team captain Meredith Furton to serve. Eversgood receives it. Bedard a long set outside for Buckman. Reardon popped it high in the air. A free ball be sent over. And didn't turn into much of a free ball. Reardon had good contact. Miller outside of the antenna. So JCA has it down to two. Buckman misses long, and now it's down to two. 20-18 our score in game three.
Again, I talk about being aggressive. The most aggressive team will have the best chance to win this third game. In the last few points, you've really seen aggressive serving out of Joliet. What got them here in this third set, they won the first set because they were aggressive, and now they're finally getting back to that. Now they have to be very efficient in their side-out game.
They've cut it to one with a run of four. 2019 Modern Day, the decisive third set of the Class 3A State Championship. Second season in a row these two teams have met in the title match. It's the third season in a row they've met on this floor in the championship tournament. 2008, Joliet Catholic knocked Mater Dei out in the semifinal. Last season in straight sets, the Angels took it to the championship. And Fred Rockers and Mater Dei looking to cast those demons aside and win its first championship since 2001. First time the Angels have been within one since it was 4-3. Meredith Burton and the Angels can tie it here. The pass takes Bedard off of the line. Schulte attacks Wyman. How about that play by Lauren Robertson?
Well, just such a heads-up play. She knew the entire offense and team from Mater Dei was sucked into the court and threw it the other direction. Great, smart volleyball.
5-0 run. Ended by Abby Winter. Allison Miller goes out. Alyssa hit pass comes on. And back to serve. Only two aces on the season for hit pass. Reardon, three-point pass to the middle. And Faye ties it at 21.
Huge swings from both teams in pressure situations. Saw that the Mater Dei blockers swinging outside. They have to make sure they get their feet set, press into the court.
That's just outside the line. Brooke Schulte thought that she had hugged the line. And can you believe it? Joliet Catholic is in front. They've scored seven of the last eight and 3 points away from a three-peat. Bedard setting up the star Schulte. Look at Hickey in the back row. On the third contact, Verton gets it across. Bedard to Buckman to Schulte. Back to Schulte, tough one to handle, but she got it down. And officials confirming for the call here. It's a point for Mater Dei, and we're tied at 22. What do you think?
Good call, that was a good call. Brooke Schulte did a phenomenal job of getting off the floor and attacking, went off the blocker's hands into the antenna. Tough call, but it was the right one.
There's a ball underneath the antenna, so one of the officials clears it. Nicole Streaker, the most accurate server that Fred Rockers has had in 35 years, sends it away. Laney Wyman. Reardon saves it. Back to Reardon. It's Schulte. Hickey with the dig. Burton with a bump set. And out of the back row, Kelly Faye.
Well, and that's such a gutsy swing. She's coming out of the back row. Hasn't taken a ton of swings out of the back row and swung as if she was in the front row. It's a gutsy swing, especially in this situation.
Laney Wyman, the only returner from last season's championship that recorded a kill. Out of the middle, Schulte for the tie. She's blocked back, but coverage from Eversgaard and outside Rockers. 23 all. Mallory Menzing serves it. This one's tight in the net. Verton's able to get it. Reardon's block recovered by Hickey, and Reardon's then dug out by Menzing. Here comes Schulte for the lead, but she's blocked back by Lauren Robertson, setting up championship point for the Angels.
Well, it's important that both teams really just settle down. For Joliet Catholic, get this serve inbounds. Make Mater Dei earn this point back. Mater Dei. Get a good pass and a nice swing. You don't have to do anything flashy. Just put this ball on the floor, get this point, and play a deuce game.
What a match this has been. We would have expected nothing less. Second consecutive year these two teams have met with a championship on the line. Joliet Catholic, 1 point away from its third consecutive state title. And it's Lauren Robertson who has five blocks in this match to serve it. For Mater Dei, a lead as big as five in this third set has disappeared.
and they have the server they want back there behind the line serving. She's been successful all night.
For the tie, Rockers got it in the corner.
Well, I think that Joliet was ready for that ball to go to Brooke Schulte. Modern Day did a nice job of balancing out their offense on that play.
Schulte to serve it. Hickey receives, falling down is Jordan Houston, and an ace for Schulte.
An unfortunate time to be slipping on the floor.
And a timeout is called by Chris Scheibe. So championship point for JCA turns into championship point for Modern Day out of the timeout from Fred Rockers.
Well, JCA, they have to have a bit of a gut check right now. Hey, something unfortunate happened, a little bit of a fluke play, but we have to respond, and they've been in this kind of this situation before, so they should be very confident. Modern Day, great opportunity to execute. Brooke Schulte back there with a great jump serve. Gonna get JCA out of system and come up with a big win.
Now Schulte does have two aces in this match already. Three times in the last 10 years, Modern Day has come to the state tournament. And three times they've been defeated by Joliet Catholic. 1 point away from snapping that run. Brooke Schulte. Jordan Houston outside for Reardon. Schulte's underneath it. Now it's Allison Miller. She's blocked back and gets another chance for the win. Diving play by Robertson. Reardon into the net. And Modern Day wins the 3A state championship. They fend off championship point and score the final 3 points. 25-15 JCA in the first set. 25-18 Modern Day in set two. And an epic 26-24 championship clinching win for the Modern Day Lady Knights in the third set.
Well, and what a hard fought match that was. Both teams playing extremely well and not so well at times. And they responded well, and in that third set, that was a state championship match against the two best teams in that class, and that they showcased their talents. Unfortunately, two teams can't win.
Sixth championship for Fred Rockers in his 35 seasons as a head coach. We'll take a break here on IHSA TV. Be back with a couple of final closing thoughts from Redbird Arena in Illinois.
And now, please meet the Angels of Joliet Catholic Academy, who finish in second place. President, Sister Faith Zembalacek. The principal, Jeff Buds. Assistant Athletic Director, Tina Kinsella. The trainer, Mark Pilara. Head coach, Christine Scheibe. Assistant coach, Katie Drabick. Assistant coach, Mary Lou Catalani. Assistant coach, Kathy Steck. Assistant coach, Kara Camarda. And members of the team, Darcy McClintock, Maggie Farner, Lainey Wyman, Haley Pennington, Elena Ragusa, Emily Shainstead, Morgan Reardon, Meredith Verton, Kate Brown, Vanessa Owusu, Jill Hickey, Lauren Robertson, Kelly Fay, Jeanette Page, Jordan Houston, Manager Caitlin Seaman, and Manager Mallory Mangum. And now will Coach Christine Scheibe and the members of the team from Joliet Catholic Academy please step forward to accept your second place trophy. And now please meet the Lady Knights of Modern Day, who finished the season in first place. The principal, Dennis Litikin. Athletic director, Dennis Trommy. The trainer, Jamie Wagner. Head coach, Fred Rockers. Assistant coach, Chad Rockers. Members of the team, Samantha Bedard. Allison Miller. Brooke Schulte. Abby Winter. Alyssa Hitpas. Nicole Streaker, Kayla Eversgird. Kaylee Buckman. Mallory Mensing. Ashley Rockers. Emily Kohling. Bailey Campworth. Allison Lampin. Abby Lubers. Chelsea Crocker. And now, will Coach Fred Rockers and the members of the team from Modern Day please step forward to receive your 3A championship trophy.
Breese Modern Day completes the season at 41-1, and the state champions in Class 3A. This is the sixth state championship in school history. All have come under head coach Fred Rockers. With us from Breese Modern Day are Brooke Schulte, head coach Fred Rockers, Kayla Eversgird, and Ashley Rockers. Coach, can you tell us how it feels to be a six-time champion?
It's super. It's great. It's excellent. It's so wonderful. Nothing is better. I should have a list of superlatives that Chad would like me to use. There's a vacant chair up here next to Brooke. Come up here and sit down and don't say anything about it. Just do it. But girls, it's your fault, and you've heard that before. But it truly is a girl's fault. They played well. They were down. They came back. They hung in there. And even real late when it didn't look very good, they stayed solid. It really helped. Now your bruises will go away, Alyssa. But no, I can't say enough for the, I think, a big life lesson of things going not well, going well, going pretty good, going not so well. And if you stick with it, hang in there, and you really, really want it, you'll get it. And like I said after the first game, are you satisfied? And they weren't. And that's the, I asked him in school. I woke up one morning at 3 o'clock, wrote this thing out, and started out with, are you satisfied? And I gave him all a sheet of paper, and I think half of them threw it away. But the last question was, are you satisfied? Are you willing to force the issue? And I think this afternoon, they forced the issue and did a great job. So this is just a super year. Girls have never heard me say those words. Super excellent, just fantastic, right? I don't say those things very often. I usually, as far as I go, is, you did a good job, way to go. If I say anything, that's about it. But no, really great. I couldn't have expected much more. And the reason I asked Chad to come up, and I think, girls, let him know how you feel about what he did this year. Give him a little a round of applause. What did he do? I was busy at one of the matches. Oh, Jamie's in here, our trainer. And I was walking around the huddle, and I told Jamie, I'm circling the wagon. And that's what I was doing. circling my wagon of such really good kids, great players, and what more can you ask?
Open for questions.
Just the monkey that's been on your back with Joliet Catholic. I mean, to get finally, you don't have any nemesis. They've kind of been a thorn in your side the last 3 or 4.
And they've been a real pain in the buns for a while, yes. But it is great. Is great to get that over with, and you guys too. You guys have really been great in our coverage, and yes, it's nice to get a win against somebody who seems like all they have to do is show up, put their shirt on, and it's over. But credit to the gals, they did a really fantastic job.
How did you guys rally after that first game? I don't know what you want to call it, but how did you rally?
I think we just had to throw that game out of our minds, not even think about it, because that wasn't too good. I mean, a lot of us were just letting it go, and then we came out strong, and obviously none of us were too happy, so we came out really strong, and our intensity was high, and we knew we had to push 2 games.
Mr. Fred. Not that the girls weren't capable of making such a comeback, but this season they've really never been in that position other than St. Joe's. Did you ever have any doubt in your mind that they could fight back the way they did?
Well, really, I really was kind of steady in my mind and saying, okay, like Brooke said, you just throw it out the window. Let's go again. Let's come at them again. Give us a chance. And that's the type of kids they are. And it's not just one person. It's really nice to have these three up here, but the other six, seven. I had trouble with words last year counting. Now I just have trouble with counting kids. But, no, couldn't do it without all of them playing their part, doing their role with the setters, the defensive players, the libero, the hitters, right, lefts, middles. We need you all, and you all did a great job during the season, and we couldn't do it without any one of them. We would be hurt if one of those kids weren't there. And the other 5 JV kids, I think, learned an awful lot at practice by playing against them every afternoon and getting an opportunity to smack back at somebody that had buried them, so to speak, on a hit.
Fred, when we talked the other day, you said kind of the diamond in the rough on this team that nobody talks about is Ashley, and maybe kind of fitting that she saved your season. Saved the match point before it all kind of worked out.
Well, Ashley doesn't know what it is to quit. That just is not part of her vocabulary. She just goes up after it and just stays with it. But I think some of the other kids caught it, or the other kids have it. They're not quitting, they're staying after it. Ashley gets to some balls and is so quick. And it's really unbelievable for some of the other teams to think that a kid is going to get to it. But Ashley's arms are quick. She jumps quick. A little patience would help once in a while, but she's that's with us all. But, no, I can't say enough about the all 10 kids. And truly they do, I think, make each other a little better.
Ashley, your guys are up 20-15, and you look like maybe you're going to win this thing, and then all of a sudden it's tied. What was going through your mind?
We just had to just stick with it and play every point out like it's the last point of the game, and we just played together and worked through it.
Brooke, you were in diapers when that 95 team won 41 matches and a state title, but I'm sure you've heard a lot about, people try to compare you to that 95 year. Just to be mentioned with them, what does that mean to you guys?
Well, you again.
I've thrown some beers out there, I guess.
That would be like
compare the.
But to have that part in history, though, of, 41 wins and a state title.
I mean,
he's asking you about the girls that had that 41-1 season and the 38-0 season.
Well, to be compared to them is an honor.
We don't read what you guys talk about on your little blog.
To be compared to them is an honor.
A number of those kids were there from the 95 team. I know both Hazelhurst girls were there. I'm not sure if Sarah Hendricks, but some of the other, some of those kids are there and do follow the team over the years. And about the biggest thing I get from them is how much I've mellowed, that's about where it goes. But they still follow us. And I think it's a different time. It's a different volleyball time. In the time of the 95, power, wow, that really did something for you. We didn't have quickness. But these guys had the quickness and some power. And just putting them in their time would be okay to say it's the best of the time. But to compare them in different frameworks, that'd be awfully hard to do. It'd be fun. Maybe somebody would do one of those computerized games. But no, it's. I think it's great. We've had some really great kids, and that's why we've won over the years. Look in the room. We have kids who are 4.0s, 3.975 because of 1B. They're really bright kids, and that's what helps make a good team, a volleyball team or any other, and they're here.
Any more questions? Is that being in your class?
Please.
Joliet Catholic Academy finishes the season 34-8 and is the runner-up in Class 3A. With us, we have Vanessa Owusu, head coach Christine Scheibe, Lauren Robertson, and Lainey Wyman. Coach, would you like to give us some thoughts on the game?
Well, I definitely thought we gave them a run for their money. We played solid in game one. Game two, it was our passing that broke down. I thought we were able to get a little momentum back near the end of that game. Game three, I think we showed a lot of heart coming back from the deficit we were down in that game also. We had match point, and it just didn't go our way. And, you know, at that point, you just got to say it wasn't meant to be for us this year.
Question. I read on a website, a Chicago-based volleyball website, that said this might be a down year for Joliet Catholic. If this is a down year, I'm sure you'll take it every time, will you?
I think so, and I think we did not think it was going to be a down year. We knew what talent we had coming back, and so, you know, what we had asked for was an opportunity to defend our state title, and I think we did that, and I think the girls can be proud of the fact that they went out there and, you know, gave a team that has been ranked ahead of them all season and who was supposed to clearly win the 3A state title run for their money.
That third game is down, you know, down 4-5, come back, tie it off. I mean, just the fight the girls to come back and
I think that shows the kind of desire and the passion that they have had all season. They weren't going to go down without a fight, and we've got great leaders on this team who were able to pick them up on the floor. And, you know, like I said, we had match point, and we just didn't, you know, things didn't go our way at the end.
Coach, just talk about for the seniors now returning. Mm-hmm. What a special run it was.
Well, Lainey's in a position she's never known as a varsity player right now because she's been on varsity 3 years, and she won 2 state titles. And these seniors are definitely going to be missed. Like I said, they were great leaders. They welcomed the juniors with open arms this year and really took them under their wings. And I think that the younger girls learned a lot from them. And now it's the juniors' turn to take over that leadership role and, you know, do their best job of combining with the upcoming sophomores. And, you know, who knows? Maybe we'll be back next year.
Coach, you had the underdog shirts on. Did you really, I mean, in your mind, or did you sell your kids? Hey, we're the...
We were the underdogs. Breese has been ranked ahead of us all year. Prep Volleyball said they would breeze to the state title, so that's the way we looked at ourselves all year long as the underdogs.
Vanessa, Lainey, the seniors, can you guys talk about just the your careers here, you know, what you guys have done? And I mean, I know it's hard to think about now, but just the awesome run that you guys have had here as seniors.
Well, for me, I mean, like, I don't like losing, obviously, but I mean, most girls only dream of winning state once or getting the opportunity to play in like a state championship game once. And, like, I was given the opportunity for like 3 times. So, like, it stinks, like, it's frustrating, but I mean, it's been an amazing season. Like, this year was so much fun. Like, the girls, we all got along so well. Like, it was just such a great season for all of us. And, like, yeah, we're all upset that we lost, but it was still fun. We still fought. So, yeah. I don't know.
My favorite part is being a part of the program, like being able to make it down here and just playing with girls that you love. And we had a great connection this year. And even in the past years, it's been so much fun just meeting new girls. Like, I know when I was a sophomore, they accepted me with open arms, and they didn't make me feel awkward or make it hard on me. They always, like, included me, and that's one thing I love about the girls here, because it's like we're a family.
Yeah, the three girls who are up here have been here all 3 years, and so they are, the other two are experiencing this kind of for the first time, too.
Coach, after playing such a strong first set there, how big of a momentum was that big run, service run that they got in the second set to kind of start turning things?
Well, in between games, I told the girls, you know, that they really did not play up to the level we expected them to play in game one, and I, you know, said they're going to come out fighting, and getting out to that 9-1 lead, I think, was huge. I do think we were able to negate that a little bit somewhat by making a run at the end, because we actually, you know, I told the girls at the end of game two, we were still winning. We had outscored them by 3 points still at that point, because we won the first one 25-15, they won 25-18. So we technically were still, you know, winning the match at that point. And it was just a matter of going out there in game three and, you know, playing as hard as we could. And I think the girls did that.
Coach, did your player say what happened on the floor when she slipped?
I haven't talked to her about that yet. No.
Yeah. Seen that before.
Yeah, I don't know what happened with that. I haven't had a chance to speak with her yet.
Any more questions?